implants used in the orthopedic surgery. Unfortunately, I could not get many of the instruments that is for you. I have 2-3 instruments with me. If I am able to complete the implant part, then I will show you the instruments also. There is a difference between implant and instrument. Implant are something which you are going to put inside or outside the body through bone. And instruments are something which is going to assist you in using those implants. Understand? So these are implants, not instruments. So in examination, if you are being asked to pick up one instrument or one implant, don't get confused. Yet pick up, for example, if I say that pick up one instrument, this is an instrument, this is a screwdriver. It helps in putting a screw. This is not an implant. Actual implant is your screw. Okay. So these orthopedic implants, they have been recently introduced into orthopedics. Don't get carried away with the idea that implants are one that helps in bone union. Bone unites on their own. For many, many years in our evolution, bone has been fracturing and they have been uniting. Only recently, with the help of implant, we are able to do better justice to the bone fractures. So any fracture, for any better management of fracture, you have to do 3 things. You have to reduce it, you have to hold it, and then you have to mobilize the patient. Reduction could be open reduction, could be closed reduction. Like for example, if you are tibia, you are manipulating it and then you bring the fracture in the alignment, you are reducing it. But then once you will leave it, it will again go back to its normal position. So after reduction, you have to hold it. You can hold it either externally with the help of plaster or internally with the help of implant. Okay, and your holding should be such that it should help in mobilizing the patient. If you are not able to mobilize the patient, then whole purpose of fracture treatment is futile. Okay, so here are the common implants that are being used in orthopedics. Okay, so let's first start with the nail. Okay, the commonest nail that is being used is K nail or puncher nail. Okay, K nail or puncher nail. This K nail was introduced for the fracture femur, and this has practically revolutionized the fracture management. I was going through, I don't know, it was some book or some social media post or somewhere where a learned person says that society has evolved when a fracture femur patient could be fit till the fracture united. Okay, so earlier what happened that with the fracture femur you have to hunt for your food and patient what used to die. But this K nail has revolutionized the fracture treatment of femur. So this was used for fracture femur. This is K nail or puncher nail. Puncher is the name of person who has invented it. It has got a clover leaf appearance. If you could see from that side, it has got a clover leaf. Okay, clover leaf is like this. Cross sectionally, it is like this. Okay, if you look at the cross section, it is like this. Clover leaf. Like appearance. Then this has got a slot. Slot this side. Okay. Slot means it is open here. It is not circumferential. It is open here. Okay. Then it has got eye. Both side it has got eye. So fracture. The femur has got bowing, anterolateral bowing. So whenever you are inserting this, the slot has to be on the anterolateral side. And these eye, they are held for extraction. So if you put inside and if you want to take out, these eye will help you. There are certain instruments, you go hook, put it inside and you can hammer it back. Okay, so these eye help you for extraction. The eye is given on both sides. because if accidentally if it was one side and if you put like this, then there was no way you could have taken it out. So I is given on the both side. Now how it works, if you look at the femur, it is anterolaterally bone. Okay, this is how the femur is. It is not a straight
femur.
If you have got femur,
yes sir.
Okay. Okay, so when you are putting a straight thing inside a bow, okay, isko chota bana lete hain. So this is your femur bow and you are putting a straight thing inside. Okay, so at how many side this is touching your bone? Three side. So the principle is called 3-point fixation. Because when you are reaming it and putting a straight thing into a curved bone, it is in the contact with 3 points, and this is called 3-point fixation. Ideal treatment, ideal fracture for this is isthmus, transverse isthmus fracture is best that can be fixed with this implant. So ideal fracture is transverse fracture at the level of isthmus. So this is Kunchar, and if you look at this is I think old implant. Okay, so a size is always written on this, like this is 10 into 9 into 34. It means it is 9 mm in width and 34 centimeter in length. This comes in the various size. Next generation to this was then people started realizing after using this that okay, there are problem if it is a comminuted fracture. You are putting this and this is a comminuted fracture. See, there are comminution here, comminution there. Okay, you have put this, but once patient will wear bed, then they will collapse, fracture will collapse. It is no longer able to hold the fracture at distance. So fracture started collapsing and then this metal started backing out. It was coming out from here, here. So next thing that come was intramedullary interlock nail. This is called IMINN, intramedullary interlock nail. Okay, now peculiarity for this is, first of all, it is curved, so it is matching the femoral profile. Okay, second, you could see there are holes. Okay, there are holes in the proximal part and distal part. The broader one, the broad and a narrow, the broader one is put proximally and this is put distally. There are jigs available which helps you in insertion of this nail. So this is kept just like the femoral profile. So it is oblique, this is oblique. Okay, so this is not like a 3-point fixation. What you have to do is, once you have put this, you have to lock it. Okay, so these screw going from outside. So you have put this, you have put your nail here, and then from outside you put locking screw, locking bolts. So you have locked it. Now if patient is going to wear bed, nowhere it is going to collapse. Okay, so this was a modification on this, and this was called intramedullary interlock nail. Why interlock nail? Because you are locking it from outside with the help of locking bolts. The screw that is used here is not called screw, it is called bolt. Okay, so with the help of locking bolts, it was intramedullary interlock nail for femur. Similarly, when it was found that okay, it is working well, tibia was anyway managed with the plaster. So next thing came was intramedullary interlock nail for tibia. Okay, both are intramedullary interlock nail because you could lock it. And tibia and femur, if you see it carefully, there is a smooth curve, okay, matching the femoral anterolateral bone. But if you look at this, there is an abrupt curve. Okay, this bend is called Herjog's bend. Okay, this is for tibia. Now how we put this, this is femur inside the patient. Femur, we open the medullary canal from here with the help of reamer, and we could put the name. But in tibia, if you want to put this nail, here is the joint, you cannot go with the joint. So what we do is, हम लोग यहाँ पे थोड़े से ओपनिंग बनाते हैं. वी मेक एन ओपनिंग एंड वी ट्राई टू पुट फ्रॉम हेयर एंड इफ द नेल इज लाइक दिस एंड इफ यू पुट इट फ्रॉम हेयर इट विल बी कमिंग आउटसाइड. सो वी हैव टू मॉडिफाई दिस दैट इट विल गो स्लाइटली इनसाइड एंड देन इट विल बी लाइक दिस. ओके, सो दिस हैज गॉट अ बेंड कॉल्ड हर्जॉक्स बेंड एंड अगेन दिस कुड बी लॉक्ड. ओके, ठीक है, समझ में आ गया. सो क्विकली पास इट ऑन ताकि सब लोग एक बार हाथ में पकड़ के देख लें.
तो नेल है फीमर का एंड कैन बी यूज इन द प्लेस ऑफ द के नेल.
या के नेल हैज गॉट अर्लियर द के नेल वर यूज्ड फॉर ऑल द नाउ के नेल इज रिलेटिवली ऑब्सोल्यूट इम्प्लांट. प्रॉब्लम इज योर दिस बोल्ट्स आर कमिंग डिस्टल टू योर फ्रैक्चर. सो इफ यू आर पुटिंग योर बोल्ट हेयर 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 so it is not going to hold your proximal fragment interlocked nail. So a third generation nail has been devised and it is called proximal femoral nail, okay, for intertrochanteric fracture. The best part about proximal femoral nail was that it had got a provision through which you can put a larger diameter